Okay, this is the first Ardennes Classics, Amstel Gold Race. We have Garo in really great shape. One of his first goals of the season. He showed Basque Country, really good team. Everyone is up to it, and I think we're going to go for a great result today.
Everyone's at a good level, and I think everyone knows their job, and everyone's really prepared to do that job. So as a group, I think we've probably got one of the strongest teams we've put together.
Well, we win. Somehow. You always have to try to win, eh?
It was the start of the Amstel. Now, the what we have done, we've sent somebody out yesterday, Mr. Jeff Banks, to do a recon for the course. So Jeff will just run through his thoughts on how the race will be run and won today.
Yeah, I mean, I watched how Robbie McEwen was doing it last year, which I thought was a pretty average job, I have to say. Because it was more about adulation from the crowd rather than actually getting the wind direction and getting the course that was like advisable for the riders. So I thought maybe I could have a go at that this year. So I rode the 150k of the course yesterday, given some of the riders, and particularly Lorenzo, one or two tips, which I'm sure they'll find invaluable. Great coffee stops. There were nice one or two hills which had some like great girls waving Australian flags at the top. So I thought the boys should know about that. So generally, it's that kind of stuff that I've been briefing them on, all the very important things, and forget the riding for a moment. That's my job.
So you guys just be prepared. If you're in a good position, once we're going over the finish, you know, we go directly into the ride, in the ride in the smaller roads. If something happens there, that we are in good position. So West, Blink and Alba. The plan. So okay guys, now we go up to that Kauberg. That's where we started the recon. Our race starts from here.
The plan.
Everyone stick to the plan.
The plan.
We know when we do it. We will make it.
Under the plan.
Come on, boys, and keep eating and drinking. On the top of the cover, we have again guys with bottles and gel.
We honor the
After
plan,
we have the feed zone, so keep eating and drinking because you see it's 24 degrees, so first heat. Come on, boys.
Honor the plan.
The plan.
Looking out there.
Yeah, it looks good.
Great, Clarky. Go on, Sam. There's only one Simon Clark.
The gap is still 20 seconds to the bunch, Peter. 20 seconds to the bunch.
There's Simon there. Simon's on him.
Come on. Come on, Garo.
The goal today was to have a clear plan and no matter what, stick to it. And we did, and Pieter had to go with the moves with about 30k to go, and that's exactly what he did, and he was in the right group. And Garo had to sit back, and it was our job to deliver Garo into that bottom corner of the Kauberg, which we did, and he got third. You know, would have been beautiful for a win, but we've got to be happy with the podium.
You know, we all want to win, and I think we had a good chance with Garo today, because if you saw how fast he was on the last time Kauberg with Gilbert, for sure he had a good chance, but yeah, there was only one guy stronger today, and he attacked like 10k to go, so yeah, you cannot say that he was lucky, so he did also a good ride.
Yeah, pretty happy with that. You know, I think we did everything we planned to do, and the team rode fantastic. You know, they were fantastic support all day. We raced the final aggressively as we planned. We had plenty of guys there in the end, and we used everyone up. Everyone gave 100%. So unfortunately, we weren't racing for the win there, and ended up in third place. But all in all, it's not a bad result.